Okay, good morning. Cloud enabling technologies. In the previous class, you discussed about the broadband networks and internet architecture. Now you are going to know about the data center technology. Later you will discuss about the virtualization technology, web technology, multi-tenant technology, service technology. These are all cloud enabling technology. By using this technology, you can, that means cloud will use these technologies. You are coming to the data center technology. What is exactly data center here? The data center, or data center, is a building or a dedicated space within a building or a group of buildings used to house the computer system. That is called here data center. You simply call it as a data center, represented as a simple building, you call it as a data center, or a dedicated space within a building. A particular building, here in the right side diagram, within a building, you will have the so many different servers available here. That means for the each and every server, they have the some dedicated space within a building, or not a single building here, a group of building used to house the computer system and associated components. Here, the associated components here is a telecommunication and then storage systems. The telecommunication systems as well as the storage system, that is called here data center. Here, the best thing here is in the right side diagram, Google data center and then Microsoft data center. Every company maintains their data center for storing the large amount of, huge amount of data. That is a main thing data center existed. And then the data center exists as a specialized IT infrastructure used to house the centralized IT resources. Yet these IT resources may be server. That means for placing the servers, databases, networking, telecommunication devices, software systems. For placing the software system, there is a house. That house, you call it as a data center. The cloud also uses this data center technology. And then the data center technology consists of the following technologies as well as the components. I think these are all are the components of data center technology. One is a virtualization, is a one type of component. Other one is a standardization and modularity, is a one type of technology. Automation is a one type of technology. Remote operation and management, high availability, the security, aware design and operation and management, another one. And then facilities also available for the data center. The computing hardware, storage hardware, network hardware, and then some other considerations you are taking. These are all are the technologies and then components. Technologies and components of the data center. Here, coming to the first one, virtualization technology. The first technology here you are using the virtualization technology in a data center. Here, the data center consists of physical and virtualized IT resources. In the diagram here, you will identify the bottom, you will identify the physical servers and then physical storages are there. And then on top of the physical server, there is a virtual machine. The virtual machine maintains a number of virtual machines. On top of this router, there is a hypervisor. The main purpose of this hypervisor is a connectivity between a physical server as well as the virtual machine. Hypervisor is there. Here, the above the hypervisor, you have the virtual server hosting virtualized IT resources. These all are the virtual server. That is a virtualization concept. In the cloud, the data center uses this virtualization concept here. Here, the physical as well as the virtualized data resources. The virtualized components that are easy to allocate. That means the virtualized, in the top of the diagram here, you have a virtualized data centers are there.
Here, what are the main purpose of this virtualized data center, including here the allocation? That means you will easily allocate the virtual machines, and then you can operate the virtual machine easily, and then you can release the virtual machine easily. That means that's a stored data in a single file. You can monitor the virtual machine very easily, and then controlling these virtual machine also the easy task. That means the virtual machine, if you use the virtual machine, the work is very easy. That is a thing, and then that's why you are in the data center technology uses a virtualization concept. And then coming to the data center technology, standardization and modularity concept. Here, standardization, standard commodity hardware. Commodity hardware in the sense, cheap hardware. That means in our systems, you are using the different hardware modules. Those hardware modules are commodity hardware modules. Here, for example, hard disk. That is a commodity, cheap hardware. Here, why you are using the cheap hardware? Here, the cost is very less. If you want to buy the 1 TB hardware, in the cost here is more than 1 lakh. But here, for the you are buying that hardware for the 3,000 rupees, 4,000 rupees, like that. That is a stand. That means in the data center are built upon a standardized commodity hardware designed with the modular architecture. The modular architecture in the sense, that means the scaling capabilities are there. Modularity. Here, modularity and the standardizations are the key requirements for the reducing the investment and operational cost. For reducing the investment, for the data center. That means these are all cheap hardware. That's why you are using the standardized cheap hardware. That means what is the main purpose here? Reducing the investment. You are not, that means instead of taking the 1 lakh rupees, for the 3,000 rupees, I can buy the 1 TB hard disk. And then operational cost also. As they are enable the economic of the scale for the procurement, acquisition, deployment, operation, maintenance processes. For these all purposes, you are using the standardization and modularity. Here, the standardization. For example, there is a modularity data center available here. That means you scale the data center capability as a requirement. As per the requirement here, you are scaling the data center capability. This is called here the standardized, the modularity, the modular data center system. Here, this data center system consists of modules and components. To offer the, what is the necessity of these modules and components here? To offer the scalable data center capability with the multiple power and cooling options. That is a main information regarding the modular data center. They introduce the modular data center. You can increase the capability. You can down the capability. That means scalable capabilities are there. Scaling up, scaling down. That means scaling horizontally, scaling vertically. This kind of scalability existed for this data center. For doing that one, you will using the standardization as well as the modularity. The standardization and modularity, the common virtual strategies and improving them. There's some of the virtualization strategies. Here already you discussed the virtualization techniques. Those are all used to improve the capability and performance of the physical design. Here for improving the capability, you are using this standardization and modularity technique. Coming to the automation, the very important thing in a automation nowadays, running the automation in a data center. The data centers have the specialized platform that automate the task. Here, which type of task is automating here? You are automating the provisioning, configuration, patching. Patching also you are doing. And then monitoring without supervision. That means everything done by using missions, that is automation capability. The advances in a data center management platform and tools leverage automatic computing technologies to enable the self-configuration as well as the self-recoverability. Self-configuration, that means the computer itself configuring the softwares, and then the computer itself recover from the any information. That is a self-configuring capability. The very important one here is a remote operation and management in a data center. Remote operation, managing the management in the sense the process cooling, that means everything managing, the power management, and then alternative energy, and then remote system access, the security, water, these are all management. That means you can manage this information in a data center. The remote operation in the sense, that means you are in the, for example, if you take the TV remote, you are sitting in your chair, you will monitor or you will change your channels. That means remote, that means you will operate remotely. That means most of the operations and administrative tasks of the IT resource in a data centers are commanded by using network remote consoles and management systems. With the help of these systems, you will manage. That means you are using the different network remote consoles and then management system. The technical personnel are not required. That means here for operating these information, you don't require the any technical person to visit the dedicated rooms. That means every time, that means that's why there exists a concept of automation. Without visiting the room of data center, that means that house the servers, except to perform a specific task such as equipment handling, cabling and hardware level installation, and then maintenance. Here, except these tasks here, everything done by using data center itself. One of the important concept here is a high availability. Availability or reliability are the different one of the concepts here. A system operate even though some of the components fail. The system operates successfully even though some of the system components fail. For example, you are driving the car. If any one of the bolt from the wheel removed, even though the system failed, the component failed, even though the component failed, but it will operate successfully. That's called here high availability. High availability is a quality of computer infrastructure. Quality of computer infrastructure that allows to continue functioning even when some of its components fail. Here, for doing that one here, there is a one, that means I collected this diagram from the internet. I collected this diagram from the internet here. Here, for doing that one here is a, there is a redundant technology is there, data center one, here active, here two, data replication. That means the same data stored in a somewhere else, data replication, the data center two. Here, these two data center operate continuously. That means in this case here, SP1 and SP2. Here, that is called here, that means you are using the duplication of data. Here, the data center outage significantly impact the business continuity. Hence, they are designed to operate with a high level of redundancy to sustain availability. That means, you know, availability concept in the sense, if any component fails, that system operate continuously without any work disturbance. The data centers have the redundancy. For doing that one here is a, you required some redundant, the multiple data centers are operate. For example, one data center, for example, Google or AWS. AWS establish one data center in Madhapuram, Hyderabad. In the same time, you will establish the another data center in Amirpet. Let us assume here, if anything happen in a Madhapur data center, that means it's operate with the Amirpet center. That means that's why in the zone availability zone, at least two data centers available. That means at least they are taking the two data center. That is a main reason. The redundant and uninterruptible power, the uninterruptible power supplies, cabling, environmental control system in a some system failure along with the communication links and cluster hardware for load balancing. The load balancing that is distributing the task to different systems. Here distributing the different task to different system. That's done by the load balancing. That is a thing in a data center technology. That is a information about the high availability. The very important concept here is the high availability. The next one is a secure, aware design, operation and management. Here the physical and logical controls and data recovery strategies need for the data center, since they are centralized data structure. Here, what is the purpose of these data structure here, physical and logical access control and data recovery strategies? To that store and process the business data. Outsourcing, that means outsourcing means you are working, for example, you are working TCS. You will work in India. You will work for the TCS from the USA. Outsourcing. The outsourcing data centers based on IT resources has been a common industry practice for decades, and outsourcing models. Here, those are all required long-term consumer commitment. And then that is a thing, that means aware design and operation management. Coming to the facilities here, what are the different facilities you are using? Some facilities may be power supply facilities, some facilities may be cabling facilities, some facilities may be heating facilities, some facilities may be air conditioning facilities, fire production facilities, and other related subsystem facilities available here. Here, what is these facilities here? The facilities are custom design locations that have several functional layout areas. Here, what are the functional layout areas here? That means functional areas as well as the various power supplies. Here it has some functional areas as well as the power supplies and cabling, environmental control stations. That means what is the environmental control stations here to regulate the heating, air conditioning, fire production, other related subsystem. For doing this one, you are required, that means the data center maintains some facilities. Coming to the computing hardware. Here, what is the computing hardware here? In the data center always maintains a standardized commodity hardware. In the previously discussed that one, standardized commodity hardware. That means the much of the heavy processing in a data center is executed by the standardized commodity hardware that have a substantial computing power and storage capability. That means required storage capability, required computing powers are there. Here, several computing hardware technologies are integrated into modular servers. Here, what are the modular servers here? Rack mount form factor server, one, and then power efficient multi-core CPU architecture and redundant and host swappable component. And then that is a thing, that is, those are all some and then some blade server technology. Here these are all different information. Here the several computing hardware technologies are integrated into those servers. such as what are the technologies here? Rack mount form factor server design consists of standardized rack with interconnected for the power network and then internal cooling support for a different hardware processing architecture. These are all 8632 bit microcontroller and 8664 bit RISC. And then the power efficient multi-core CPU architecture. Here, what is this hardware information here? The power efficient multi-core CPU architecture that houses the hundreds of processing cores in a space as small as a single unit of small rack. Redundant and hot swappable component. Here, what is this one here? These are all hard disk. Redundant components are there. Hard disk, power supply, network interfaces, storage controller. These are all different controllers, different hardware components you are using. And then computing architecture. Another one is a computing architecture. What are the computing architecture? Blade server technologies. Here, blade server technology uses a rack embedded physical interconnection. And then fabrics is one of the computing architecture. That's it will use as a switches and then shared power supply unit and then cooling fans. This interconnection enhance the intercomponent networking and management while optimizing the physical space and power. Here, coming to the another important technology is a storage hardware technology in the data center. Here, what is the storage hardware technology? That means the data center has a specialized storage system. It maintains a amount of digital information. Always stores, for example, 1 GB data. In the 1 GB data stored in a external drive or internal drive. Here, in order to fulfill the storage capability need, the storage systems are constrained housing the hard disk that are organized into arrays. Here, the storage systems involve the following technology: hardware disk array, I/O caching, hot swappable hard disk, that means hard disk, let us assume, storage virtualization, fast data center replication mechanism. These are all are the some of the technologies which are involved in a storage systems. Here, for example, hard disk array. Everyone knows about this information here. Here, hard disk array in the sense, here divides and replicates the data among the multiple drives, and it increases the performance and the redundancy by including space disk. Here, another important one here is I/O caching. Here, what is I/O caching here? I/O caching that means this is performed by using hard disk array controller. Here, by using hard disk array controller, you will performing the I/O caching here, which enhance the disk access, disk assets time and performance by using caching. What is the necessity of cache memory? The main memory, cache memory. The cache memory main work here is a fast accessing of data. Fast accessing of data. That's one here caching. Coming to the hard swappable hard disk. Here, what is the hard swappable hard disk here? Here, this can be safely removed from the array without requiring prior powering down. The storage virtualization. One is the storage virtualization. Here, this is a realized using use of virtualized hard disk and storage sharing. Next one, fast data replication mechanism. Here, what is the fast data replication mechanism here? The fast data replication mechanism include snapshotting and then snapshot. But means in the mobile phone, you write in snapshot, which is saving the virtual machine memory into hypervisor and then readable file for the future reloading, volume cloning. Here, these are all different information for the fast data replication mechanism. Not only this replication mechanism here, you have a volume cloning or physical hard disk volume and partitioning. This is about the storage hardware. Coming to the, this is something about the storage hardware consists of these categories: storage area network, network attached storage. Here storage is area network. Already you know SAN, the physical storage media connected by using dedicated network. That is called here storage network. Here these storage networks provides a block level storage access by using industry standard protocol. Here which type of protocol you are using? The small computer system interface. And then network attached storage, NAS. Here hard drive array. This is a hard drive array that contained and that's contained and managed by this dedicated device. Here this NAS connect to the by using network and facilitate access to the data using this file centric data access protocols like a network file system or server message block. With the help of these protocol, you will connect it to the data center or file data center. And then coming to the network hardware, that is a storage hardware. Coming to the another one, network hardware. Here, what is a which is a one of the technology network hardware, data center technology. Here, the data center requires network hardware in order to enable the multiple level of connectivity. For the multiple level of connectivity, for enabling, you have this technology. Here, that means for simplified version of networking infrastructure, the data center is broken into 5 network subsystems. Here followed by the, that means what are the 5? That means the for the simplicity, for the simplified version, you are dividing the data center into 5 network subsystems. Here, what are the 5 network subsystems? Here, the 5 network subsystems are, these are all 5 network subsystems. The external network interconnection, carrier and an external network interconnection, peptide, load balancing and acceleration, LAN fabric, SAN fabric, NAS gateways. Here these are all are the some of the network subsystem. That means you are, in this case you are dividing the data center into these 5 subsystem: carrier and external network interconnection. What is the carrier and this one? The subsystem related to the inter networking infrastructure. This interconnection is consist of backbone routers. It's having the always backbone router. What is the work of this backbone router here? To provide a routing between a external WAN connection and data center LAN, as well as the network security devices such as firewalls and then virtual private network gateways. Here, what is the backbone here? It's having the backbone router. What is the router here? It provides a external WAN connection and data center LAN as well as the network security devices such as the firewalls and then virtual private networks gateways and then peptide load balancing. Load balancing in the sense distributing the task to different location. Here load balancing and acceleration. This subsystem consists of web acceleration devices. What are the web acceleration devices here? XML preprocessor, encryption and decryption appliances, and then layer 7 switching devices here that perform the content aware routing. That is a main thing here. Here the system always consists of the XML preprocessor. Here coming to the LAN fabrics. Here what is the LAN fabrics here? It provides a high performance and redundant connectivity for the data center network enabled IT resources. Here this technology implemented by using multiple network switching. Here that means it performs the several virtualization functions. This the LAN fabrics perform the virtualization function. What are the virtualization function here? LAN segregation into VLAN, link aggregation, control routing between a networks, load balancing and failover. These are all different technologies, different functions done by the LAN fabrics. SAN fabrics. Here, what is a SAN fabrics here? This provides a connectivity between a server and storage. Here, for providing a connectivity between a server and storage, you are using the one of the network hardware that is called here SAN. SAN in the sense storage area network. The storage area network fabric is implemented with the fiber channel FC and then fiber channel over the Ethernet FC OC OE and then InfiBand network switches. This is a something about the SAN fabrics. Here other one is a NAS gateways. Here what is a NAS gateways? Here this subsystem always supplies a attachment point for the NAS based storage devices. Here for the NAS storage based devices always supplies a attachment point. That means link. It provides a link, and this implements a protocols conversion, a protocol conversion hardware that facilitates the data transmission between a SAN and NAN devices. Here, the data center network technologies have a operational requirement for this scalability, high availability. The scalability in the sense, easy to scalable. That means without any thing. That means that's why there is a virtualization concept existed. High availability that are fulfilled by employing the redundant and fault tolerant configuration. Here, in the last concept in this data centers technology, what are the other considerations here? The hardware is subject to rapid technological information. Here, with life cycle that typically lasts between 5 to 7 years. The security is another major issue when considering the role of the data center and the vast quantities of the data contained within its goal. That means for referencing, you will see this refer.